if anyone's interested in being added to the Green Infrastructure Network email list, please let me know. We'll let you know about more information sessions like this. And so we'll get started now. Our first speaker is Eric French. He's from ICER Landscapes. He's the president, and he's going to start the presentation today with green roofs.
Okay. All right. Good morning, everybody. Thank you so much for coming out. I'm looking across the room, and I see a lot of familiar faces. I also see a lot of folks I haven't met before. And I think we've got a great wide variety of folks in here. We've got people that are boots on the ground, like myself, a little dirt under their nails, my suntan, out here getting this stuff done. We've got guys that are administrating, getting it paid for, and we've got folks that are designing it. So it's good, everybody. It's here. We've got a good cross-section. Feel free at any time to raise your hand and say, hey, what, stop me and feel free to ask questions. A lot of these slides we're going to run through are projects that we were involved with. We either designed or built or rebuilt. I'm going to be critical of some things, and it's mostly my work I'm going to be critical of. So if for some reason I've got something that one of you designed up there and I'm being critical, don't take the heat, okay? most of this stuff is our stuff. So we're going to start off with green roof maintenance. So just a quick show of hands. Does anybody know what a green roof is? Some familiarity? Okay. I'm going to start this from the beginning on most of these and sort of take it through the steps. Okay. That's a green roof. All right. There's actually a building underneath that thing. Wouldn't expect it looking at that photograph, would you? But that is a green roof. There are basically three types, three to four. Engineered soil covered with vegetation, and typically that vegetation is sedum. What we're trying to do when we're doing a green roof is we're using these as stormwater control. We're trying to slow down the water that's going down the roof drain and into the sewers. Especially in Pittsburgh, we've got a combined sewer problem. Most of you would know this, some of you might not, but the pipe that takes the stormwater off the gutters of your house ends up being the same pipe that takes the poo when you flush the toilet. So it all ends up going into the same pipe, heads down the river, goes down to Alpesan, if that's the drainage basin we're in. The problem is that as little as a quarter inch of rain overruns that system. So the plant cannot manage or handle purifying the water to put it back in the river. And all up both Vermont and Ohio, there are overflows. So we get too much rain, the gate pops open, the rainwater, the poo water, everything ends up in the river. Okay? So this green infrastructure, the big picture, I'm taking this 5 miles up, the big picture is we are trying to keep the storm water out of the pipes. We're trying to keep them out of the storm system and out of the combined system and keep this overflow problem that's happening downriver from happening. So we're going to do this with green roofs. That's what I'm going to talk about right now. So we've got basically this extensive, I'll show you that. There's a semi-intensive, and it has a 5 to 8 inch soil profile. We grow a different type of plant population. And then we have an intensive, which is essentially 6 to 8 inches or deeper. We put some of these roofs on, we've got 3-4 feet of soil on them. Now, the structure needs to be designed to handle that weight. And you'll see where I've got a few weights up here. For the extensive, that can be as little as 10 pounds, the 35 to 40 pounds, and then the semi is a moderate weight. Again, the intensive can go up to 300 pounds or more. Okay, there's ultra lightweight, which I'll show you further down the road here. Now, as far as the extensive green roof, this is essentially an extensive green roof. This is a 4-inch layer of an engineered soil matrix with a sedum green cover. Okay, so all these green roofs, what they have in common is you've got soil, we've got plants. For the thin layer of soil, we're using sedums. The reason we're using these plants is because they can handle the drought stress. Okay? And interesting, you know, as time's gone on, more and more and more research has been going on. We're finding one of the things they found out was that those populations of plants, seeing them when they're dry, especially like the last 8 weeks we just had with no rain, and if you haven't watered that root, that plant will essentially, it's actually a sponge, it'll lose all its water. The first rain, the plants can absorb up to the first 1/4 inch of rain, just the plants. And that doesn't include what's going to happen with the soil. So you can see we're going to take a lot of water out of the system, especially when it's dry. Now, when it's wet, if it's been raining on a weekly basis or it's been raining on a daily basis, what's happening is we're going to end up sort of short-circuiting a little bit. You're going to absorb water, slow it down, but you're not taking it out of the system. You're slowing it from going down the pipes. Okay. This is another extensive system, and it's not super clear here. Let me get this pointer to work. There we go. This is put in with a tray system. So there's a couple different types of methods of installing the green roof, an extensive green roof. One is with trays, and another is with sedum carpeting, with sedum mat. And the third type is essentially you can literally break up, take and cut and prune this stuff back, break it up in your hands, walk out across your soil, drop little bits, and it takes about a year to 2 years before it'll actually revegetate completely. So it's a good way to save money if you're working for a nonprofit and you're in a situation where you've got a tight budget. Now the maintenance, and I'm gonna basically get you up to speed on green roofs, and we'll go into maintenance. But you know, maintenance is different for all these types of roofs. This is a semi-intensive, a little more aesthetic. Aesthetically pleasing. A lot of people look at a sedum roof as just a big flat piece of green. It almost looks like a piece of grass. You do get a little bit of flowering in there with various sedums. Mostly that's in the spring. These semis, you can get perennials, some small shrubs, sedums, and you basically, this type of roof, we want to have in an area where people can see it. And then, of course, this next is another semi. Okay? That's only got about, that particular job's got about 6 to 8 inches of soil on it and different plant color. And again, there's that intensive I showed you. And that particular project had up to 4 feet of soil, and it was a sand matrix soil. So you can grow trees and shrubs. Now, another thing you can do with these, with the green roof is plant a meadow. This was actually a seeded wildflower meadow. That's on the roof of a building. That thing's about 5-6 stories in the air. Okay? That roof no longer exists. We had to take that and reestablish the plant colony. The problem we have with this, it was beautiful. I mean, I love this roof. But the people that were in the building, in the offices, couldn't see out of their windows. all that wildflower got 3-4 feet tall, and everybody felt like they were in a cave. So we ended up literally taking this off and redoing it. But it was an exceptionally successful planting, and it was nothing to seed. It was just seeded. Now it's also irrigated, and we got about 18 inches of soil. Now you can see it here. You know, what do we got here? That guy doesn't belong.